and gentlemen, in today's video, I am going to be ranking my top 32 wide receivers in the NFL currently.
This should be fun.
Can you guys do me a favor on this one and at least watch the video before commenting that the list is trash or that I don't know ball? Because there is a couple of you who literally don't even watch the videos and you're already talking trash. It's cool, it's part of my job, but like, you gotta at least see what I'm saying. Couple of plugs before we hop right into it. Don't forget to use code WyattsWorld on G Fuel or Prize Picks, where you can save yourself a discount on any G Fuel products or match up to $100 of your first deposit. That's all I got for plugs though. Let's get into my top 32 NFL wide receivers. Okay, so I have the wide receiver list set up the same exact way we do every other list, but I do want to mention real quick before we start this that this is the weirdest position and probably the only position that I can say with this list, there's not a single bad receiver on here. Like, there's just too much talent to go around in the receiving position. If you make the top 32 list, like, you're good. So in other words, please don't take it as an insult if you're at the bottom, but some of you will. But anyway, beginning with number 32, give me Jaden Reed out of Green Bay. I think he's the best looking receiver on that team, and he's a multi-tool as well. You know, his rookie year, Jordan Love's first year as a starter, the guy throws up 800 yards, 8 touchdowns, and also runs for 100 yards and 2 rushing touchdowns. Really liked just about everything I saw out of him last year, and I think Green Bay would be rather silly to not be super aggressive with his usage this year. I think he's actually gonna blow up. Moving on to 31, give me Zay Flowers, another speedy, electric receiver with a great set of hands who had a fantastic rookie season last year. It's just the only thing about Zay that I'm concerned about is why his targets seem to go from like 3 to 10, back down to 4, up to 10, back down to 2, back up to 10. And I'm not sure if that's on him or Lamar or both, but it just makes him look a little spotty. Moving on to 30, give me Tyler Lockett. I'll give Lockett the respect that he deserves. He's been a very, very good receiver in the league for probably, what, 7-8 years now, but it drives me absolutely nuts that this guy falls to the ground every time he catches a ball. I can't say it enough. He's consistent, he's reliable, but if you need him to fight for an extra 5 yards to get a first down, he ain't gonna do it. Now we're on to 29. I'm not sure if I should put him on the list or not, but I will. Rashee Rice. Not looking at the stupidity he did this offseason and just looking at the year he had last year, I think he showed a lot of signs that he could be a foundation in the Chiefs offense going forward, you know, if he doesn't get in trouble. I mean, this guy had 930 yards, 7 touchdowns, sat a regular season game, and then absolutely obliterated Miami in the playoffs for like 130 yards and a touchdown. And that'll bring us to 28. Give me Jordan Addison. Now, he gets a little bit of a bump above the other rookies because, yeah, he only had 70 receptions. He only had 900 yards, but he had 10 touchdowns while alternating between 4 different quarterbacks his rookie year. Cousins, Jaren Hall, Josh Dobbs, Nick Mullins. No reason he should have done as well as he did. And Jefferson being hurt definitely helped him, but I'm just saying he is a damn stud. All right, now moving on to 27, give me D-Hop. Definitely still deserves to be in a top 32 list, but this guy is getting old. He is physically slowing down, and he is also complaining more than I've ever seen him complain in his career. If he doesn't catch the ball, it is not his fault, and he is going to scream at any official that is within his fucking eyesight. It's a little bit sickening. Now we're at 26, give me Scary Terry McLary. Consistent, reliable, limited. That is kind of how I have Terry at this point. Like, to be fair, he has never had a consistent quarterback. He's never had a consistent offense, which makes it impressive that he has been so consistent. But we have now just witnessed our 5th year of Terry putting up Terry stats, Terry being Terry. Right around 1,000 yards, right around 5 touchdowns every year. It's good. It's not the best in the league, especially in today's league. Now 25, give me Calvin Ridley. I think he was a little underrated last year, I'm not gonna lie. 76 receptions, 1,000 yards, 8 touchdowns. The guy still runs like he's 22 years old. Probably helps that he had to take a year off, but I still think he's got a lot of pop in his step, and people gotta stop acting like this guy just threw up the worst receiving season ever because we were expecting him to do a lot more than he did, but he's not bad. Now moving on to 24, give me Michael Pittman. Now, this guy's kind of had a Terry career too. He just never has a consistent quarterback, never has a consistent offense, kind of always throws up, you know, the same numbers every year. However, he just had the best receiving year of his NFL career with Gardner Minshew as he logged in 109 fucking receptions last season on the Colts. Why do I not remember hearing about that? Michael Pittman is a workhorse. And now moving on to 23, we've got Chris Olave, and I really did want to put him higher. It's just that this is the point in the list where everybody is a little bit too close, and he's stuck where he's stuck. I have no complaints about him. He's been in the league for 2 years. He's had 2,000-yard seasons. This year, he had an improved season, having 87 receptions compared to his 70-some last year. His only thing holding him down at this point is I've seen him do good things. I just haven't seen him do as good of things as pretty much the people who are going to be listed above him. Okay, 22, give me George Pickens. This might get a little bit of hate because a lot of people do not like him, but he is actually a monster. He does push off a lot, but he is a beast. Guy just had 1,100 yards off of 60 receptions. That's like 18 yards a catch. This ain't a guy to look at for a 4 to 5 yard gain. No, you're gonna throw him a little floater or a check down and he's gonna turn it into a monster play. Number 21, give me Jaylen Waddle. I still love him to death, but like I said, at this point, the talent is it's just too close and too matched up to have him any higher. I think he's one of the smoothest receivers in the league. He just looks so clean and confident when he's out there. However, we do have to acknowledge that his numbers have just dropped every year since he's entered the league. However, he is playing alongside Tyreek now. Now moving on to 20, we've got Cooper Kupp. Stop acting like he's a top 10 receiver in 2024. He's still good, but he's getting old and he's getting hurt all the time, man. He hasn't had over 900 receiving yards in the last two seasons. He hasn't broken 6 touchdowns in the last two seasons. I think I brought this up too, but go look at his catch percentages last year. Like, he's just not the same. 19, give me Devontae Smith, the Slim Reaper. If he wasn't playing alongside AJ Brown, he would be a top 10 receiver in the NFL. I get his size bothers some people, but like, you don't understand. He has never gotten hurt in 3 years, and he makes just as big of an impact on the field as anybody of any size. Crazy effective receiver. And now moving on to 18, give me Deebo Samuel. Look, as far as multi-tools go, he's probably the best and most effective multi-tool in the league. He's very good at his job. He's an explosive fucking runner. But you gotta face the facts that he's not the receiver he was 3 years ago, and he never will be again. He's never gonna have 1,400 receiving yards in a season again. Great player, but just how high can we still put him? All right, moving on to 17, give me Garrett Wilson. He's probably been in the worst predicament for a receiver to be in, yet he has done phenomenal things for what he's been given. I mean, 95 receptions. Bouncing around between Tim Boyle, Zach Wilson, and Trevor Siemian, imagine what he's gonna do in a full year with Aaron Rodgers. 16, give me Nico Collins. He exploded this year. Not enough to really put him into the top 10 if you're asking me, but enough to have him sniffing that conversation. 80 receptions, 1,300 yards, 8 touchdowns, like 16 yards a reception. Brother's acting like he's prime Julio or something. 15, give me Keenan Allen. Coming off arguably his best season ever, 108 receptions, 1,200 yards, 7 touchdowns. But he again missed 4 games. He's 32 years old. Much as I would love to see him continue to dominate, I think logically we can assume that he is just going to start to dwindle down. No hate though, 15's a great number. 14, give me Amari Cooper. He's been one of the most underrated receivers in the league since he's been a Cowboy. And I think he's all the more underrated now considering he's another prime example of a receiver who hasn't had a consistent quarterback, yet he's still making the most of it. Matter of fact, he had the most productive year of his career this year. 1,200 yards, 5 touchdowns, averaged 17.4 yards a catch. Amari's a dog. 13, give me Stephon Diggs. You wouldn't have put him that low if he was still on the Bills.
And I will argue that one because he ended last year absolutely horribly.
Don't get me wrong, the guy can still play. He can still run a mean route every once in a while, but he doesn't have the hands he used to and he doesn't get the separation he used to.
Buffalo fans say this a lot, and I think people think we're joking, but he was literally like non-existent in our offense the entire second half of the season.
Now moving on to 12, we have DK, still an absolute dominant beast. Pure impact player. He doesn't make small plays. You get him the ball, he's gonna throw someone on their ass and he's gonna take off down the field for 20 yards. Like, to me, it feels like this guy has been forgotten about since Russell Wilson left the Seahawks. And he's been just as good, except he's just not getting double-digit touchdowns anymore.
And number 11, give me Big Mike Evans, the most consistently dominant receiver we will ever see in our lifetimes. He's been in the league since 2014, and it doesn't matter the team or the quarterback.
Well, he's always been on the Bucks, but his roster's changed is what I'm saying. This guy has had 1,000 yards every year. He is still averaging 15 yards a reception. He's still breaking double-digit touchdowns. We have no reason to write him off. Like, he's been Big Mike, and he still is Big fucking Mike.
Moving on to 10, I'm gonna give it to Puka Nacua. This guy broke 2 rookie records in both receptions and receiving yards. He had 1,400 total yards, 105 receptions, 6 touchdowns, averaged like 14 yards a catch. For the people who are saying, I need to see more out of him, what more do you need to see? Moving on to number 9, give me Davante Adams. He might be old, but he is still gold. Last 4 years, he has still broken 100 receptions, still broken 1,000 yards, and this year was actually the first year out of the last 4. He didn't break 10 touchdowns, he only had 8. At 31 years old, you can expect him to start slowing slowing down like Keenan, but at the same time, his last 3 years, he has not missed a game either, so he's still 9. Moving on to 8, give me Brandon Ayuk. This guy is a menace, dude. He's crazy fast. He will get up and get any ball down thrown at him. Also, another receiver that averages like 18 yards a catch. If you're asking me, man, not only is he better than Deebo now as a pure receiver, but he has been night and day better than Deebo for quite a while. Now we're on to 7, give me DJ Moore. This is a guy that everyone thought was gonna have the worst year of his career after he went to the Bears and ended up having the best year of his career. 96 catches, 1,300 yards, 8 touchdowns with Justin Fields, who could not throw the ball consistently to save his life. Ask yourselves honestly, how many times last year did he turn nothing into something? Because I'm pretty sure I would need 3 hands to count all the occasions. And now moving on to 6, we got Ja'Marr Chase. He is really good. I have no complaints about him at all. Absolute freak talent the last 3 years he's been playing. It's just that this year, well, he spent half the season with Jake Browning, who is absolutely serviceable, but Ja'Marr isn't going to get the best version of himself unless he has Joe Burrow or an actual starter. So I do feel like he was held back slightly, even though he had a good year. All right, now moving on to 5, give me Amon-Ra St. Brown from the Lions. And again, this is just pretty much personal preference at this point. I have zero complaints about him. I think he is a key foundation into the Lions' success. He has gotten better every single year in nearly every category since coming into the league 3 years ago. And anyone even trying to argue saying that he was overpaid is just a jealous football fan that wishes they had him. Now moving on to 4, give me A.J. Brown. And him and Amon-Ra are really close. It's just that I've seen AJ dominating for a little bit longer than Amon-Ra. I mean, this guy is just a big muscle, man. He's impossible to tackle. He's impossible to contest a catch with because he's just gonna bully you out of the air. Now, the one knock AJ does have is he's known to have some attitude issues. But if I was as good as him and I'm not getting the ball either, I'm probably bitching myself. 3, give me CeeDee Lamb. Everyone's gonna hate that one, but it's just the facts. 135 receptions, 1,700 yards, 12 touchdowns. If it was Ja'Marr Chase that did that, everybody would be lobbying for him to be the next president of the United States. People just hate CeeDee and they hate Dallas. 2, give me Tyreek Hill. He might be 30 years old, but he has been arguably the best receiver in football since he went to the Dolphins from the Chiefs, where he was supposed to fail. Remember when Patrick Mahomes made his career? Well, that's what some people wanted to say anyway. Back-to-back 1,700-yard years, back-to-back 119 reception years, 13 touchdowns this season, averaged 15 yards a catch. This guy was literally everything to the Dolphins. And 1, call me biased, but we got Justin Jefferson. And I know he didn't play an entire year, but he also broke 1,000 yards in the fewest amount of weeks in the history of the NFL by a receiver. He has the highest paid contract for a wide receiver in the league for a reason. And he's flat out just the most well-rounded receiver out of anybody in the league. I really think he has everything. Elite hands, elite routes, elite speed, elite work ethic. And the best thing about him is he's not one of those guys where if he's banged up and his team isn't doing well, he's gonna nag out his injury. No, he wants to get back and play. He's just an absolute baller, and I have no issue saying it, even though it sounds crazy that if he played all of last year, he would have been the leading receiver. Go look at his game logs. The facts are there. He is the best. And that is going to be it, ladies and gentlemen, for my top 32 current NFL wide receivers. Hope you guys liked this video. I'm sure I'm going to catch a lot of flack, so let me know where you disagree in the comments. As always, though, I had a ton of fun making this video. I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your Monday, and I will see you in the next video.